And the other part, what are the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what are the meanings of these names? And mashallah, you will find the scholars wrote many books about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's continue talk about the rules, yani, or like short and quick review. We mentioned that one of the rules, Asma Allah kulluha husna. All the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are perfect. Asma Allah kulluha husna. All the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are perfect. And also we mentioned the rule about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Asma Allah tawqifiyya. What is the meaning of that Asma Allah tawqifiyya? It means you need a proof from the Quran or authentic Sunnah for every single name. So it is not allowed for any one of us, any one of the scholars, to claim this is a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without a proof from the Quran or authentic Sunnah. And also we mention one of the rules of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you come across any of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or his attributes, you should not resemble Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his creatures. With the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you read, for example, the name Al-Malik, the king, or when you read the attribute Al-Yad, that Allah has hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has face, you should not resemble Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with any one of his creation subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. He has a how, and we have a how, but different. So this is very important when you come to understand the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we spoke about that the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of them have meanings. And the correct meanings of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not like us. Not necessarily that our names have the same meaning. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his names, Al-Qawi, and he is Qawi. The strong, and he is strong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Ghafoor, and he forgives. But people, maybe you find someone, his name is Jameel, beautiful, but he's not beautiful. His name is Kareem, but he's not generous. So when you talk about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are meanings from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, when we spoke about the number of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are not only 99 names. But what is the point from the hadith of Bukhari, that Allah has 99 names, if you memorize them, if you know them, the meaning of Ihsa, you enter paradise. Okay, so from his names, which are more than 99 names, there are 99 names, specific 99 names. If you memorize them, if you know them, if you apply them in your life, you enter paradise. Okay? And this is also one of the points we mentioned last week. What is the meaning of ahsaha? In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, man ahsaha. Maybe sometimes in translation we find man ahsaha, the one who counts the names of Allah, or the one who memorizes the names of Allah. But Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned the levels of the word man ahsaha. One of the rules regarding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his attributes, that the names and attributes which affirm the meanings more than the names and attributes which negate the meanings or the negation. Again, yani, when you read the name Al-Malik or Al-Quddus, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Muhaymin, Al-Ghafoor, Al-Jabbar, Dhul Jalal, Al-Kam, these names, all of these names affirm something, a meaning. When you go to the second type of the names or the attributes, they negate. For example, ليس ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. No one is equivalent or equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No rival for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is negation, not affirmation, negation. Allah la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. This ayah affirms the name Al-Hayy and Al-Qayyum. Allah la ilaha illa huwa Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum. Then, لا تأخذه, this is negation. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. He doesn't sleep, subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, when you come across these attributes in the Quran, what you will find, which is wrong, to affirm or to negate? To affirm. More. And the negation less. This is one point. And another thing, you will find the attributes which affirm for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in details. While the negation, usually in general. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. No one's like Allah. No rival for Allah. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيًّا. No one is, no one like the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِي شَيْءٍ. Nothing like Allah. Most of the time you'll find the negation general. Why we are mentioning this, or why the scholars, why do the scholars mention this point? Because you'll find in some books of Ahlul Bid'ah, the deviant sects, they focus on the negation. Allah is not up, Allah is not down, Allah is not right, Allah is not left, Allah doesn't move, Allah doesn't. You'll find no, doesn't. Or you'll find negation in details, opposite of the Quran. And no doubt this is wrong way. We should affirm what is mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah. As it came in the Quran and Sunnah. طيب. So this is very, very important. طيب. Let's mention a point that we did not mention last week. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what? الأسماء الحسنى, the perfect names. طيب, إن الله سبحانه وتعالى مشى وذروا الذين يلحدون في أسماء, and leave and avoid those who do إلحاد and his names. طيب, so this is very important point. We should know what is the meaning of إلحاد. طيب, in the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Okay, generally إلحاد, yeah, maybe now if you find that, yeah, if you translate the word إلحاد, atheism. Okay, but we are not talking about this. Ilhad in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Basically, the word ilhad from al-lahd. Al-lahd means al-mail. To be in, not straight, in curve. Like what we do in our maqbara. In the graveyard, okay, and in Kuwait, what is the way? There are two ways to make the qabr, to make the grave. There is lahd. And the second type, shaq. What is the difference? If you notice, okay, if you check inside the maqbar, the qabr, the grave, okay, what you'll find here in Kuwait, you'll find they dig about 1 meter and 20 centimeters, or 1.5 meters down. At the bottom, what you'll find, there is like a groove aside. Toward the Qibla. Okay? So when we put the dead, the janazah, inside the qabr, then we put his face toward the Qibla. Sah? You notice? So this groove, the side groove, this is called lahd. Why? Because it is a side. And the second type of janazah, of graves, they will make it in the middle. They will make it in the middle, not side. So I don't know in your countries. In Bangladesh, middle or side? In middle. So this is shaq. This is called shaq. Okay? This is allowed, but this is allowed. But it's better to make it lahd. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, "Al-lahd lana wa shaq li ghayrina." Lahd is for us and shaq for others. So it's better to do lahd. But both of them are okay. Both of them are okay. Okay. So, what is the meaning of lahd? Lahd, mail. Not straight, you go, like deviation. So, generally, the meaning of lahd to go straight or deviation. So, what is the meaning of lahd? Sorry, ilhad in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means that you are not following the correct way in understanding the names of Allah. You are going here or there. طيب. What are the types of إلحاد in the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى؟ Number one, to deny the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Like الجهمية. There is one sect called الجهمية. They are the followers of الجهم of Safwan. Okay? He is a very deviant man. Maybe from the Tabi'in or Tabi'in people. Okay, he denied the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, Allah has only one name. What about that is no. Why? Because if you prove several names of Allah, this means there are several gods. This is not logical. What is the problem if you give two names, one person? Yeah, for example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is Muhammad and he is Ahmad. This means he is two people? No, one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Malik al-Rahman al-Aziz, and he is one. But he has several names. So this is deviation and understanding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is, for example, Mu'tazila. They have the deviation denying the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another kind of ilhad, Al-Mu'tazila. They prove the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, yes, we agree. Allah is Al-Malik al-Quddus, the names of Allah. But when you come to the meanings of the names, they don't agree with us. No, so Allah is Rahman bila Rahman, Ghafoor bila Maghfira, Malik bila Mulk. Not logic. He is the most merciful but without mercy. He is the forgiver but he doesn't forgive. How? No, we should not attach any attribute with the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they proved the names without the attributes, without the sifat, and without also the actions. And subhanAllah, maybe you will not find this clearly now, but you will find some of them in the books, tafsir or the aqeedah. So you should be careful when you read the books, especially the tafsir. يعني, for example, when you come to the word the ayah Surah Al-A'raf, يعني for me, if I find I'm in the bookstore and there is a new book of aqeed as a tafsir, directly I go to Surah Al-A'raf. This is the first thing I do. I go to Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 54. ثم استوى على العرش. Okay, what is the translation or what is the meaning of ثم استوى على العرش? This is very important. So you find most of the books of tafsir, I don't mean the modern, but the old ones. Most of them, okay, don't translate or don't make the correct tafsir. استوى على, in the Arabic language, what is استوى على? Like استوى على السيارة. He rose above the car. This is the meaning, as a linguistic meaning. But they change the meaning. They say استولى. Allah ثم استوى على العرش, which means he rose above the throne, subhanahu wa ta'ala. They change the meaning. They say استوى means استولى. What does it mean استولى? This bottle with someone else, so I take this bottle from someone. This is استولى, with power. Okay, but this is haram, to make istila, like a country invading another country. This is haram. This is not fair. And also another thing, when you understand that Allah, يعني استغفالله, when you say that Allah استولى على العرش, it means the throne was with someone else, then Allah took it from him. So this is totally wrong. So maybe you will not find a book like the Mu'tazila, exactly like the Mu'tazila belief, but you find some of them, some of the points. So this is also ilhad, to deny the names of Allah or to deny the meanings of, or the attributes of the names. Also ilhad, to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a name without a proof. Like some of the books, maybe philosophy or the Christians, they call Allah al-ab, the father. Or the philosophy book, they say al-illa al-fa'ila. Okay, يعني the reason which is doing, the thing which is doing. Say Allah and خلاص. They cry here and there. مسبب الأسباب. Okay, so this is also الحاد. This is deviation in understanding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't give any name without proof from Quran or Sunnah. Also, we mentioned now three types. Okay, I hope that to write, okay, or to memorize, because there will be exam. Okay, and if you pass the exam, maybe there is sabusa, ولا برياني, or nothing. ما أدري. هدي رفيق. شنو في؟ If they pass the exam, دعاء. دعاء. The best thing دعاء. طيب. Also, to derive names from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the asnam, for the idols. أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّى وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. The scholars say they derive the kuffar, these names from the names of Allah. اللات from Allah. العُزَّى from العزيز. ومنات from المنان. Okay, so also this is ilhad, this is deviation in the names of Allah subhanahu, in understanding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Mannan, one of the names of Allah, not Al-Hannan. Okay, Hannan is not a name. I mean, it is not authentic hadith. The authentic hadith came with the name Mannan. Mannan, not Hannan. طيب. So these are the meanings of the الحاد في أسماء الله سبحانه وتعالى. الحاد, which is the deviation in the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. طيب. There are والله many books about the names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I mean the meanings in Arabic. In English, well, I don't know. يعني, I have here one book, طيب, written by عبد الرحمن سكينة. But in Arabic, there are many books. يعني, for example, this book, maybe brief book. طيب, every name in one page or one and a half, not a book. But this is a bigger book about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this book, three volumes. I brought only one volume. This volume, yeah, this, for example, the first volume, more than 600 pages. So, يعني about 2,000 pages, 2,000 or 1,800 pages about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. About the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, but in this book, يعني details, يعني about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a book also, I do not bring this book. This book by when. This book also written by his sister. Also this book written by his sister. Where are the brothers? Okay? No, they wrote, alhamdulillah. This is by Sakina, and this is by Nawal al-Eid. Nawal al-Eid, not from Kuwait in Saudi. And there is also a book by Egyptian Sheikh, 11 volumes about the names of Allah. I do not mean this book. 11 volumes about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you find many books about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarized. Medium size, big size. Why? Because this is very important. It is very important to know your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We mentioned that last week that to know the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with khushu', with submission, if you understand the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran about the scholars. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The scholars. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari rahimahullah said about the ayah, إِنَّمَا يَخَافُ اللَّهَ فَيَتَّقِي الْعِقَابَ بِطَاعَتِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ بِقُدْرَتِهِ عَلَى مَا يَشَاءُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ وَأَنَّهُ يَفْعَلُ مَا يُرِيدُ. Who fears that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he will avoid his punishment by his worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said the scholars. because they know the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he can do whatever he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a saying by Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala an, لَيْسَ الْعِلْمْ عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الرِّوَايَةِ. The knowledge is not to narrate a lot of hadith. He said the real knowledge is khashya, the fear. And he mentioned the ayah إِنَّ مَخْشَى اللَّهِ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ العلماء. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أَنَا أَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَأَشَدُّكُمْ لَوْ خَشَّى. I am the most one who has knowledge about Allah and also I fear Allah the most. So if you notice, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم put the connection between the fear of Allah, the khashya, and the knowledge. أَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ. Okay, what is the meaning أَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ? It means to know the names of Allah and His attributes سبحانه وتعالى. And also it was said من عرف ربه فقد عرف نفسه. The one who knows Allah, the one who knows his Lord, he knows himself. If you know your Lord, then you can know yourself. من, the one who knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, what is the meaning of this statement? The one who knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he is free of need, al-ghani, then you know that you are poor, you are needy. Ya ayyuha an-nas أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله والغني الحميد. The opposite. You are in need and he is free of need. And if you know that Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني to know that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is eternal, doesn't die سبحانه وتعالى, then you know that you are going to die. كل من عليها فان. Everything on the earth is going to die. ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. Who will remain? Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And if you know that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the most knowledgeable with knowledge, then you know that you are ignorant. والله يعلم. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. And Allah knows and you don't know. Okay, what is the point here? The point is to show you that we are the opposite. Allah knows and we don't know. Allah is he is the living subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-hayy, and we die. So if you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his great names, perfect names, you will know yourself that you are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the importance of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we say in our dua every morning and evening? بسم الله الذي لا يضر ما اسمه شيء. You notice the hadith? بسم الله الذي, this is very strong dua. بسم الله الذي, in the name of Allah, الذي لا يضر ما اسمه شيء. ما اسمه, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the protection, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the food halal. When you slaughter your sheep or your cow, with the name of Allah it will be halal. Without the name of Allah it is haram. Okay? وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. The name, اسم الله, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا أرسلت كلبك أو كلابك المعلمة وذكرت اسم الله. Okay, this hadith about the ruling and hunting. And this is an exception for the dog. You can use the dog. But which dog? الكلب المعلم, the trained one. So he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you send your learned dog, المعلم, and وذكرت اسم الله, and you mention the name of Allah. So even if you are using the dog, okay, the one which is trained, okay, then, and you say Bismillah, when you send the dog, you say Bismillah, then the sight is halal. What you hunt through you, the dog, is halal. Without Bismillah, it is not halal. So, subhanAllah, what is the difference? The name of Allah, subhanahu, وتعالى. طيب. Let's start the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no specific order. I will start with, يعني every book has its own way in يعني the order of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Let's start with Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Okay, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Because, you know, both of them relate to the attribute of Rahman, so we'll mention them together. Like inshallah when we come to Al-Ghafur Al-Ghaffar together. Al-Razib Al-Razzaq together. Like this. Al-Shakir Al-Shakur. طيب. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. No doubt these are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they came clearly in the Quran and also in the Sunnah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The first surah in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So two times in Surah Al-Fatiha. And of course, the first ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, some scholars say it is from Surah Al-Fatiha, the scholars say not from Surah Al-Fatiha. Okay, so, but there is hadith, Shaykh Al-Bani mentioned this is an authentic hadith. He said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it is one of the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it is one of the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. So, this means in Surah Al-Fatiha, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim came two times, twice. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So now we have clear proof from the Quran that ar-Rahman and ar-Rahim, two names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the Sunnah. From where? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reciting Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in Surah, in the Salah. In the Salah, he was reciting Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So these names, authentic names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. What about يعني, the meanings of ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? Both them from ar-Rahman, the mercy. Both names from the mercy. But are they the same? As a rule, there are no identical or the same names in the Quran. For sure, there is a difference. There is no two identical names. And even when we come, inshallah, to Al-Malik, there is a difference. Al-Shakir, Al-Shakur, also there is a difference. So now, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, these are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes. The same, exactly the same? No. Both of them about the rahmah, about the mercy? Yes. What is the difference? Some of the scholars said, Ar-Rahman for everything, and Ar-Rahim for the believers only. Ar-Rahman for everything, and everyone. Also the kafir, yes, there is rahmah. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the kafir to drink, to eat. This is a kind of rahmah, as a general rahmah. But there is a specific rahmah for the believers. Why they say? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. He did not say رَحْمَانَ رَحِيمًا. So from this ayah they say, the difference between الرحمن and الرحيم, الرحمن general and الرحيم specific for the believers. Another يعني opinion, الشيخ بعثين المشن, الرحمن بالرحمة الواسعة والرحيم بالرحمة الواصلة. يعني when you are speaking about the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He is the most merciful, so He is الرحمن, full of mercy. But when you are talking that He is, has mercy upon this animal, upon this person, so you mention the name Ar-Rahim. So when you are speaking about Allah, generally He is Ar-Rahman. But when you are using يعني, as a verb, so we mention Ar-Rahim. Okay? So this is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. How many times these names came in the Quran? Ar-Rahman, about 57 times in the Quran. And Ar-Rahim, okay, more than Rahman. The name Ar-Rahim, more than Rahman, more than 100 times. Ar-Rahman, ala al-arsh, Ar-Rahman, sorry? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, there is a difference between the scholars. Okay, now about Surah Al-Fatiha, we mentioned. Some scholars said it is from Al-Fatiha, other scholars said not from Al-Fatiha. If it is not from Al-Fatiha, so is it a separate verse from every single surah or not? So some scholars said it is a separate verse. But no doubt it is there in the Quran. We read to differentiate between every surah and the next surah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And also, they agree, the scholars, that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it is one verse from Surah An-Naml. Surah An-Naml, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the letter from Sulaiman to the king of the queen of Saba. Innahu min Sulaiman wa innahu. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So no doubt, this is a verse. No doubt. So this is ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and the meaning is ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Can we name ar-Rahman to people? No. This is not allowed. Ar-Rahman is this special name for Allah, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But ar-Rahim, yes. And it came for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. But Rahman, no. There is, you know, the one who claimed the prophethood after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are some people who claimed the prophethood, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that some liars will come claiming that they are prophets, like Musaylam al-Kadhdhab, al-Sajjah, al-Aswad, some people. So Musaylam al-Kadhdhab, he called himself Rahman al-Yamama. Rahman al-Yamama. But no doubt he's kafir. He's claiming that he's a prophet, he's kafir. Okay, so Rahman, the name Rahman is not allowed for anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Rahim, yes. Came for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah At-Tawbah, the end of Surah At-Tawbah. Ar-Rahman, if you notice, it is a special name. قُلْ اِدْعُوا اللَّهَ أَوْ اِدْعُوا الرَّحْمَنَ. And also the kuffar doesn't agree with this name. The kuffar, I mean the kuffar of Makkah, the disbelievers of Makkah, they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you ask them who created you, immediately they will tell you Allah. But they don't agree with the name Ar-Rahman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran. وَهُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ بِالرَّحْمَنِ. And they disbelieve in Ar-Rahman, which means in this name. It doesn't mean they disbelieve in Allah. They believe in Allah as a creator. But they deny this name Ar-Rahman. They deny this name Ar-Rahman. What do we need when we study this name Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? To know his name and his attribute Ar-Rahman. This is one of the most important attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman. And also we should differentiate between two things. There is Rahma makhluqa wa Rahma kasifa. There is one mercy which is created. Allah created 100 mercies. إن الله جعل 100 رحمة. جعل هيمن means خلق. Allah created how many رحمة? 100. And He revealed one of them that we are using now. If you find any kind of mercy, this is from one رحمة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And He kept the 99 رحمة where? For what? For يوم القيامة. So when you read this hadith talks about which rahmah, the one which is created. But here we are talking about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as an attribute, as sifa. So Allah is ar-Rahman rahim, and one of his attributes, ar-Rahmah, the mercy. So when you come to the Quran, what do you find about the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He says, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Which means His mercy is vast, enough for everything. It is not limited. Okay, you know something, subhanAllah, who's the most merciful person for His children? The mother. But subhanAllah, His mercy for her children, not for others' children. Or if it is for other children, not for every children, all the children. So her rahmah, her mercy is very limited. But the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wasi'at kull shay, for everything. It is enough for everything, sufficient for everything. And also the carriers of the throne says, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا. You know Allah, your knowledge and your mercy. Okay, includes everything or covers everything. The rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one point, that the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very vast, not narrow, not limited. Another point about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the opposite of mercy? What is the opposite of rahmah? الغضب, the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَّا قَضَى الْخَلْقِ كَتَبَ عِنْدَ فَوْقَ الْعَرْشِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the things, okay, He wrote with Him above the throne, إِنَّ رَحْمَتِي سَبَقَتْ غَضَبِي. My mercy before my anger. رَحْمَتِي غَلَبَتْ أَوْ سَبَقَتْ, okay, my mercy overcome my anger. Brother, sister, you know, the scholars use these points from aqeedah sometimes in the fiqh issues. Yani, maybe the scholar, if it is a fiqh issue, and they come to a point, they reach to a point, they don't know this opinion or this opinion is correct. Because we have this school, the other school. So they reach to a point, we don't know which is stronger opinion. So one of the points that, as a foundation, the mercy is stronger than the anger. So they say, which one is, we think it is easier? This opinion, khalas. We'll give the fatwa according to this opinion. Of course, not from the beginning. Please don't misunderstand me. Not from the beginning. This is at the end. If they reach to a point, we cannot say this is stronger than this opinion is stronger than the other. But as a general rule, mercy is stronger than overcome the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, لو يعلم الكافر ما عند الله من الرحمة ما قنط من جنة أحد. If the disbeliever knows how much of mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, he will not lose the hope of entering paradise. But subhanAllah, what is the problem? The kafir, the disbeliever, doesn't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doesn't know his attributes and his names. ما يفتح الله للناس من رحمة فلا ممسك لها. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the door for His mercy, no one can close this door. And there is a saying in Kuwait, inshallah it is not in your community, not in English, India, and this is wrong. If there is a bad person, we say, or an evil person, shirir, yani tyrant person, we say, مَا يَرْحَمْ وَلَا يَخَلِّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ تَنْزِلْ. This person doesn't have mercy, and he doesn't let the mercy of Allah to come down. This is wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهُ. No one can stop the mercy of Allah. But this saying says, okay, some Kuwaitis say this, he doesn't allow the mercy of Allah to come down. And this is wrong. Because if Allah wants to have mercy upon someone, no one can stop this mercy. But what you can do, to correct this saying, we say this person doesn't have mercy, and also he doesn't like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on someone. He doesn't like. But it is wrong to say he stops the mercy of Allah. No one can stop the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, some people don't have mercy. The man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he noticed him kissing the kids. He said, تُقَبِّلُوا صُبْيَحْنَكُمْ. Is it normal that you are kissing your kids? I have 10 kids. I don't kiss any one of them. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أو أمرك أن نزع الله من قلبك الرحمة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what can I do if Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني remove the mercy from your heart? You don't have any mercy in your heart. You have kids and you are not kissing your kids. شنو هذا؟ سبحان الله. Also, the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is great. لله يعني the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told the companions how much is the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى vast and strong. And he gave the example. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم likes to take the chance يعني to show it practically. He saw a woman searching for her kid after a war or something like this. So when she found her kid, she put her kid, her baby, on the breast to suck the milk. Of course, he's hungry. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you think that this woman will throw her kid in the hellfire? The companion said, of course not. Impossible. She will not do that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told that, said, الله أرحم بعباده من هذه الولديات. Allah has more mercy than this mother with her mother, with her baby. So this is the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. One of the scholars, Hamad ibn Salama, said, رحمه الله, ما يسرني أن أمري يوم القيامة صار إلى والدي إن ربي أرحم بي من والدي. Okay, I'll not be happy, okay, at the day of judgment, that the one who was making hisab for me, making my the account on me, the reckoning, my parents. No, my Lord, His mercy more than my parents. Subhanallah. That rahmatullahi subhanahu wa taala. An-nubuwa rahma. The prophethood. As a mercy, rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قَالَ يَا about the Prophet Nuh, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي وَآتَانِي رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِهِ وَآتَانِي رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِهِ. So the prophethood is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the other ayah, أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Do they like to divide, يعني, to decide the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means the prophethood? لولا أنزل يعني, they say, why Muhammad is the prophet? Why this man, why this man is not prophet? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Do they like to choose who is the prophet? So the prophethood is rahmah, mercy. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also is a mercy. وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. Yeah, brothers and sisters, we need to connect the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى الرحمن and His name الرحمن الرحيم and His صفة الرحمة with the آيات الحديث. And also, it is important when I mentioned at the beginning that the names الرحمن الرحيم mentioned the Quran more than 150 times. Which means Islam is the religion of rahmah. These points, wallahi, we need to realize, we need to think deeply about these points. We need to, يعني, to show the world these points with numbers. Okay, يعني, for example, one of the names of Allah, Al-Jabbar. Al-Jabbar. Who defeats the tyrant. Allah, Jabbar. And also it has another meaning, who heals the broken hearts and bones. Okay? If you check how many times the name Jabbar in the Quran and how many times the name Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. This is important when you do a statistics about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, for example, when you come to the names of Rahman al-Maghfirah, mercy and forgiveness, Rahman Rahim al-Ghafur al-Ghaffar. How many times? No doubt you will find these names more than Al-Qawi, Al-Qahhar, Al-Jabbar. Okay. We should show the kuffar, I mean the non-Muslims, these statistics. To show them or to prove for them. Okay, not for us because we know our religion. For them. What you think about Islam is wrong. طيب. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمة. And also the Quran. ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة وبشرى للمسلمين. Also the Quran is رحمة. And also being a Muslim, this is رحمة. قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. Being a Muslim, this is the biggest رحمة. Mercy. It is better than what you collect in dunya. Houses, palaces, cars, whatever. الرحمة.